Hey Potters, welcome to episode 128 to CosPod, the podcast for all things cosplay. Welcome to all of our new listeners that we have accumulated after Halloween. Incidentally, happy Halloween, everybody, and post Halloween, happy discount candy day.
And pre-turkey day.
Yes, and also happy Day of the Dead for those who celebrate it.
Or Veterans Day today. Oh man, there's just too many holidays now.
Today when we're recording this, today is
Veterans Day. Yes. Yeah. And happy birthday to my dad yesterday. He turned 65. Yay! Daddy's old. Daddy also got a BB-8 droid as his gift. He was playing with it. It was very cute.
While we're at it, happy birthday, Bob Ross.
Yay! There we go. Oh, sad face. Didn't Twitch do another marathon with him?
Yes.
Nice.
I watched where I could, which was not much, unfortunately, but you do what you can.
Yeah. Then, you know, it's Bob Ross.
Yes. And on a side note, as the days are getting longer, the days are getting shorter. The nights are getting longer.
There we go.
Yeah. And we're getting closer to the food season that is Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Woo!
I did want to mention that this is also charitable giving season, and we do have several charities that we personally support. You can see those on our homepage. If you have charities in your local area that you prefer to support, please do. Please consider donating money or time to local food banks and to local homeless shelters, because they could really use the help. Local kitchens as well. This time of year, people are in need more than usual because of the holiday. And it's been all over the news here locally recently that there's been a lot more demand at local food banks, but people just aren't picking up with donations. And so they're being really strained. So if you can, please do give to your local. We fully support this. We also fully support volunteering, whether it's in cosplay or out. And tomorrow, as of this recording, Rooster Teeth is actually doing their extra live stream.
I thought they did part of it last week, or maybe I'm
off. They did the community last weekend. They're doing
gotcha.
The official stream this weekend.
Yeah.
They didn't want to interfere with some of the other streams that were going.
Makes sense. I think that's what we're going to end up doing next year. We met our goals, and I met my goal. It was still a really big push towards the end where it was like on the verge of like begging people for money. Like, come on, just like, please, even a dollar, a penny. I'll take a penny. Penny would be great. But because Extra Life has now gotten to the point where it's so inundated with so many people gaming at the exact same time, people don't know where to exactly put their donation towards. So it's like,
right.
Wherever.
Since Extra Life, you designate the charity that you are playing for. So it's not necessarily the national Extra Life charity. It's the local chapter of Extra Life.
So I think what we'll end up doing is just probably moving it to sometime in the summer. That way it's a good halfway point in the year. It gives people enough time to kind of rebuild their funds again. And it's an odd time to donate. It's not something that people typically think of. So they may actually have a little bit of extra cash on hand and be like, oh yeah, I can help throw in a couple bucks. Because we found that having our first day in October, we got more donations that way. So I think we'll probably do that again. Still fun though. Still had ridiculous amounts of fun. Amber got to sit in for a little bit. That was fun.
Yeah, I basically sat in as soon as I got back because I was off being a professional over the weekend. I actually spoke at a conference and gave a panel.
Oh, cool.
Basically, as soon as I got back and put away all my groceries that I had to get and ate food, then I sat down and watched what was left of people's extra life. Sorry, guys.
You know, it is a thing. Have to
I
adult.
Was effectively not here for the day, so.
Mm-hmm. Adulting, it's a thing. It's all good.
But it was awesome, and I'm really glad it's over with.
It's a thing that we have to do now.
It's one of those things where people will say that you did a great job.
Yeah.
They mean it, and they're genuine. But you're kind of sitting there just going, oh, God, I was a nervous wreck. I was so anxious.
Oh, yeah.
And,
every time,
you know, I didn't even go through my entire outline. I missed this, and you're so self-critical.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm always like that whenever I teach panels. And I think that's part of why I do so well at them. But even if I do well by other people's standards, I'm still always beating myself up over
it. Oh, that's always the case. I mean, everybody does it because you're always like, man, I forgot to do this. I didn't do this right. It's like my PowerPoint's all screwed up. How did this happen? I mean, yeah.
And that's why I'm really glad it's over.
It's done. You can move on.
Pretty next much panel. Until the next one.
Next panel. There's always a next panel.
But speaking of cosplay updates, unfortunately, I don't really have too much, except for it's the last time that I spoke with you guys as Potters. I did a wedding, so I did wear the dress.
Yay.
It worked magnificently. Everything great. Was great. Everything fit. Nothing happened in terms of costume malfunctions. Unfortunately, I was bug bitten, but there was absolutely nothing I could have really done about that besides maybe worn bug repellent, but I didn't realize I was going to need it, so I didn't bring any.
Whoops.
But basically, that's done. So I'm debating pulling it apart and reusing the fabric for other things because it is a very nice heavy satin. It would work really well for a coat lining. Because I have this desire, even though I live in Texas, where cold is not cold, as I want to make my peacoats.
Oh, that'd be cute.
The really nice, trendy peacoats, and just line it with the brown satin.
Yeah. It's good for like the...
It's just to be lined in satin.
Yeah, it's good for like the 5 times out of the year when it's uber, uber cold enough when you're kind of walking from your home to your car and you need that coat for like 10 seconds. It's like the one time. Yeah. It's like the one time it's good.
It's like, man, I should use this for something else that I'm actually going to wear.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, the sewing practice is always good.
It's a reason to be cute for 5 times out of the year.
Yes. So aside from that, I have actually been seam ripping curtains apart to use for quilt for my bed. And I have finally finished ripping through all 6 curtain panels that I will eventually finish. And now that the conference is over that I spoke at, that was basically my last major deadline for the year of stuff I have to do, which is absolutely astonishingly relieving.
I'm sure it is.
So now I can sit and work on Soraka. Now I can actually work on my next cosplay in a somewhat leisurely fashion.
Good. That is always helpful.
Yeah, and actually I can use my ranger overcoat pattern for the overdress for most of it.
Nice.
I just have to figure out how to make the collar stand up the way it does in the picture. And purchase some components over Black Friday.
That's coming up soon.
I know.
Too soon.
All of the ads have started leaking.
Yeah, they have.
Also, this is not my personal cosplay update, but I did want to mention that the winter collections for Simplicity and McCall have come out. For some reason, they seem to move really quickly from fall into winter. And I don't know why. It's a lot longer of a delay between spring, summer, and summer to fall. But it's really short. It's like 1 month between fall and winter. But do have a look at their new patterns. They've got some decent stuff out if you are into vintage costumes, vintage cosplay, as in 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s. They're really pushing hard on that right now. Also, the other thing I wanted to mention is that Riddle has joined Simplicity as one of their pattern producers. She does a production for them. And she just came out with her first bodysuit pattern. Now, Riddle is with Simplicity. Yaya is with McCall. So now all we need is somebody to get with Butterick and maybe Vogue, and then we'll have all the major ones covered.
Will we now? Is that all of them, Diamond?
That's not all of them. There are others like Berta and Quixo.
Okay.
But those are subsets of McCall for one.
Yeah, yeah.
And two, those generally aren't used anymore. Quick can be used, but they tend to be very simple because they're meant to be quickly sewn.
Thus the name, Quixo.
Yes. Yes. So there aren't as many costume applications for them unless you're using it as a base. And Berta has somewhat of a smaller collection size. Slightly less to choose from.
Here's Val's knowledge of patterns. Mm. and it shows.
They have some really nice stuff. There's not too much cosplay stuff, but there have been plenty of patterns that have come out recently that you can use for cosplay stuff. And then, of course, there's a little geeky thing like the hooded scarves that they came out with recently.
Right.
That you can always do for winter. So there are things. And I am understanding that Joanne's is running their sale through, I believe, tomorrow.
I think so.
For Simplicity and McCall. So if you need patterns, unfortunately, by the time you guys hear this, it's not going to be any good.
It's going to be too late.
Sorry. There's always next sale. Or there's Black Friday.
There's always sales, especially this time of year. There are always sales. You'll find what you need.
We'll be talking about that later in the episode.
We will be. We have some great ideas for cosplay gifts for the cosplayers and costumers in your life.
You have cosplay updates first.
Yes, I do. Hang on. Let me stick this one pin in, or I'm not going to
stick a pin in it.
I'm going to stick a pin in it, and it's going to look like a ratty mess. It's glorious. So this is what I've been working on for the past hour. I just got a bunch of stuff for my next cosplay that I'm working on in between my Game of Thrones beading and embroidery of death. This is for a Final Fantasy IX costume. And I've just figured out recently that if you order from Arta Wigs and you don't need the wig immediately, they send it to you pretty fast. However, if you need it in like 3 days, they take like a week and a half to get it to you. So just kind of keep that in the back of your head. If you ever really, really need a wig, probably order from somewhere else other than Arta, because it'll take forever to get there. Anyway, so this came in like 4 days earlier than it was supposed to. So I figure, yeah, I can take a beating break and I'll start adding in the pounds and pounds of wefts that I got to stick in this sucker, which is why it looks like she got electrocuted right now. It's glorious. So glorious. So yeah, this is what I've been working on. And in between this and the beading, and you guys have seen the beading progress. It's just a giant line of beads at this point. It's just going to be endless. I think, gosh, how many feet does it need to be? It's going to be about 20 feet of beads that I'm hand sewing. When it's done, I'll be happy to show you the final process, because yeah, it's just going to look the same until then. And it's going to be very depressing. So other than that, I don't really have a whole lot else that's going on, just keeping myself entertained with this puppy. And I have started my streaming this week. I am going to do my best to stream tomorrow. Question, maybe. I got a busy day tomorrow, but I'm going to try and stick with it. It helped me get back on track and do more of this type of stuff while I'm streaming, kind of get into the cosplay thing. That's all I got. It's not very exciting, other than it just looks really funny right now. My one qualm that I have, and feel free to chime in on this, Amber, is that no matter where you buy the wefts from, short wefts are never really quote-unquote short. They're always long.
And the longer, even longer.
Yeah, the super uber duper long ones are uber annoying. Like, I'm using only short wefts, and you can kind of see here, the straight pieces are the wefts and the curlier pieces are the wig. And the straight pieces are about the same length as the wig. And this is a medium length wig. This will come to below my bust line and then some. And it's just annoying, because this is supposed to be a short wig when I cut it all out. It's only going to be maybe my shoulders. I would like to get like short wefts that are actually short. Maybe even like double up on the amount of the wefts because they're shorter. I don't know. Because it feels like I'm just going to be wasting a ton of hair, because so much of this is just going to get cut off.
This is going to be an episode about gifts that you can get the cosplayer humor in your life.
Yay!
For holidays. And since Black Friday, Cyber Monday, and all of the major sales are coming up.
Can I just say I'm a little disappointed in Google that they don't have like a Santa hat listed in their effects? Because this would be like the opportune time to put like on a Santa hat or like elf ears. Nope, those aren't options. Thanks, Google. You just suck right now.
I would like to enter this that we're going to be fairly general on this. Basically, these are gifts that any costumer, any cosplayer would be able to use. I'm making X character, I need this. We're not doing that. All right, so things that you can get cosplayers and costumers end up being from the usual suspects, namely craft stores and online specialty stores.
Right.
All right. So first off, I'm going to go ahead and go through the entries that we got on our Facebook page.
Okay.
Mentions, gift cards are always a good choice. Whether it's Amazon, Joann's, a Visa prepaid, or an Arda golden ticket, it's never a bad idea. I'd agree. Generally, gift cards are things that you can always use somewhere. I would say for something more general, you'd probably want to stick with Joann or Amazon. Mm-hmm. The Visa prepaid is okay, but sometimes those have fees attached to them when you purchase them. And of course, there's always that you can watch out for when they do the deals, like you get a $5 gift card if you buy a $25 gift card. Those are always handy. All right, so next up, we've got from Allie, samples of thermoplastics to play with and some craft sewing organization stuff. I'm running out of places to keep stuff.
Which I have that problem all the time. Every time.
Yes. Yes. You can never have too many boxes and bins, whether it's for holding thread, whether it's for holding all of the different types of scissors you have, holding paint bottles.
Yeah, I mean, you can also think about things like shoe storage. Like, you can see these hooks on top of my closet. That's all of my cosplay shoes. They're hanging off on the inside of my closet, so they don't take up too much space. And the same thing with like garment bags and getting nice hangers for your cosplays. It sounds dumb, but they're things that cosplayers need.
Vacuum storage bags.
Yep.
Space saving bags.
Yep.
For storing all the fabrics. Because you have to have a place to store all of your excess fabric that you're not using.
Do you? No.
Well, you need to keep it dust and dirt free, which the bags help with. And since they're the vacuum type of bags, they don't take up quite as much space.
Yeah.
And you can use a standard vacuum cleaner with those. So you don't have to have anything special. So that is certainly to consider. Lots and lots of storage, yes.
Mm-hmm.
This one is from Claudia. I'd like craft foam, pins, and tailor's chalk. Also paint primer and cosplay. Craft foam is usually a safe bet. Even if you're not an armorer per se or a prop maker per se, even if it's not in the final costume, you can still use it for patterning. And it's cheap, and it's especially in the large rolls now.
Yeah.
Joann's.
Yeah, definitely go for the large rolls. Don't get the small sheets. Get the giant roll. That's so much better. Way better.
You can go for the small sheets if you're getting the thicker stuff, because they don't sell the thicker stuff in the large rolls yet. The 6 mil, they only sell it in small sheets. Getting the 2 mil stuff, that comes in the large rolls.
Then you better not be a cheap ass and only get like 2 of those sheets. Get like 50 of those sheets.
Maybe not 50. Or, of course, you can always give people the traditional little tomato, which you can see mine has 10,000 pins and lots of needles already.
Oh, holy crap. I didn't realize how many pins that thing had. Jeez, holy fudge.
It has pins everywhere.
Oh, my God. Okay, you make mine look really tame. Hang on a second. Mine is just sad right now. It's just got nothing in it. I recently replaced it, though, so.
Yeah, mine is quite old. In fact, the little... that has sand in it.
Yeah.
I actually ended up getting glue on it. So now the sand is hard and I can't stick pins into it anymore. So it's kind of a useless like rock now.
Okay. Oops.
Yeah. It happens. I need to replace my tomato anyway.
There you go. Christmas gift right there. Tomato. Sewing the tomato.
It has been a good tomato, to be fair. It has served me well. Now I need one of those little wrist magnetic pin cushions.
I've been thinking about getting one of those. Those seem really handy.
Or heck, they even have the little tomatoes that you can mount on your wrist too, so that you can hold it up here instead of having it down in front of you.
There you go.
Whatever it takes so that you don't lose them on the floor or in the sofa so that you find them with your feet. Or your pets find them. Or your kids find them.
I would much rather find them than my dogs find them. So far, that has been the case.
Mm-hmm. And also chalk. I don't
Taylor's chalk.
I was going to say, I use the Crayola stuff that comes out of the box. But it works.
It does work, yeah.
It works. It's washable. Makes a fairly thick line, unfortunately, as opposed to a thinner line. But again, it works. It does what I needed to do.
And there's different types of Taylor's chalk that you'll find. If you go through like Dharma Trading Company and even on Amazon, they have different types for different fabrics. So if you have a friend who does like a lot of spandex stuff, they've got a Taylor chalk for that. So keep that in mind too. And they're relatively cheap.
Yes. And the idea with most of these gifts is that we'd like to keep them under, say, $25.
Or if you want to go like full bonanza, I got a couple of kit ideas too. They're still probably under 50 though, so hey.
Actually, one of mine is a kit, because those are the ideas that we had on our Facebook page. But one of the things that I would get somebody would be a hot glue gun kit. But it wouldn't be one of the cheapy glue guns like the AdTech stuff, which I admit I use. I use the AdTech ones.
Yeah, I got one.
But I was just informed DeWalt actually makes a hot glue gun.
Yeah, they do.
Apparently it makes the AdTech ones look like third world glue guns.
They look like children's toys.
Yeah. Apparently the quality is that much different. So I would get somebody one of those and then get variety pack of the glue gun sticks that they have at the store that come with like two or four of each different type. Because if you haven't seen now, they have lots of different types of hot glue sticks now. You can get the glitter kind, you can get the glow-in-the-dark kind, you can get glossy versus matte kind, you can get all sorts of different colored kinds. So many. You can even get the ones that have frosted effects in them.
You can get the Mod Podge melts.
You can get Mod Melts, which are technically not hot glue sticks.
But.
But you can get them. They are a little more expensive. Just FYI, guys. They are a little more expensive than the hot glue sticks. They are about $8, if I remember correctly. $8 for 10 sticks. It's about a dollar a stick. If you're going to go that route and get somebody Mod Melt sticks, I would highly recommend that you spring and get them one of the molds that goes with it. And don't just give them the sticks, because while you can, Mod Melts are meant for casting. They are thermoplastics. They are meant to be used in molds. And they sell all sorts of different kind of molds. They have a gem set that I think would be really useful for cosplayers. You can cast a whole bunch of tiny little gems that you can then use nail polish and paint over.
You know what I've actually used it for? As I used it for my Ray Earth armor, a lot of the edgings on the top pieces and then on my knee pieces was done with Mod Melts. It was a great way to seal the Wonderflex that I used too. It gave a nice little singed tint to it.
That's definitely a good way of go. A good way to go. The other one that I came up with pretty much on the spot was a scissor kit.
Yeah, I have that listed too.
Because we don't use our fabric scissors on not fabric kids.
Save the fabric scissors.
All the memes going around saying, I will cut you if you use your fabric scissors on anything else that is not fabric. You can actually purchase scissor kits at Joann's.
You can, yes.
Sells kits. You can get two or three different scissors in a kit. They come with dressmaker shears, a pair of shears, micropoint shears, which are the little itty-bitty embroidery-style ones. Mm-hmm. And then occasionally in the kits, you can also get a more generic set, which is the set that you would use on everything that is not fabric.
Good God, yes. Multiple scissors. I think I'm at the point now where I have five different pairs, I want to say. Three of them are fabric-related. One of them is my junky pair of scissors. And then what is my other one for? I have another pair of junky scissors, but they're larger. I don't know what I use it for. I have too many scissors.
Six pairs across from me.
They all have a reason. They have a purpose.
And if you know somebody who works on wigs a lot, you'll also want to consider getting them a pair of wig shears.
Yeah.
Which are not the same as general scissors or Dressmaker shears.
That's what it is. That's what it is. I have not this pair, but I actually have a larger pair that got downgraded to my wig shears. Now it's, I just use it for wig cutting only. Because wig fibers are so much different than any other fibers that you will ever work with. They will dull scissors very, very quickly. So don't ever mix it with other things, ever. Maybe craft foam. That's about it.
Recommended if you get a pair of shears that is just for cutting wigs. And they actually make special wig cutting scissors that are made to keep their sharpness for as long as possible, obviously.
Right.
And there are shears for different types of things like feathering and such. You can get razors. So there's all sorts of little cutting implements that you can get. If you know somebody who works with foam and prop making all the time, you can always get them a nice X-Acto knife and then a couple packages of spare blades, replacement blades. You can get somebody a rotary cutter. If you know they work a lot with straight lines, you can get them a cutting mat to go with it.
God, get the rotary cutting kit. Oh my God. It comes with them. It's the mat. It's the cutter. You get the rulers. I am so glad I made that purchase. It's like the best thing ever. Which is dumb because I've been doing this for how long and I just recently got a rotary cutter.
So I've got two other kits. The first one is a ruler kit, which most people probably wouldn't think about.
Mm-hmm.
You use rulers all the time.
All the time.
So get somebody a good metal straight edge.
Yes.
If they need to cut against it. Make sure it is at least 12 inches, if not longer. I would prefer 15 or 16 inches just because we use long rulers whenever we do dressmaking. You can also get them a set of French curves, which are really helpful when doing blocks or slopers. If you make your own patterns, those can be incredibly helpful. They can also be really helpful in prop making whenever you have to smooth edges. French curves usually run you about $5 or $6. They're cheap. And you get a set of four. All different kinds of curves. And they're decent. They're plastic, but they're still decent. So you get them that, and then you get them a yardstick. And if you want to be really fancy, you also get them a cloth measuring tape.
Ooh, yeah.
So you have a giant measuring kit of things. Yes. The last kit that I had in mind, and then I'll stop talking, is the basic adhesives kit. Get some E6000.
The glue kit.
Yeah, get some Mod Podge, get some tacky glue, get some Fabri-Tac, get some fray, I think they call it fray stop or no fray.
Yeah, or fray check. Yeah, it's like they got like four different terms for it now.
It depends on the company that sells it. But get them that. Fusible web. Usually they're sold under Stitch Witchery, but I prefer the actual Fuse and Bond because Stitch Witchery is thin.
Yeah.
And then they also have the non-fusible fabric adhesive strips where you just press. And I found that, again, you need to get the Craft and Bond brand because that will work a lot better than some of the off-brand stuff. I used it on the wedding dress, actually. And it held up beautifully. So I would get all the adhesives and then, of course, the master of all adhesives, super glue.
Yeah, of course. Super glue solves everything. We like the little kits like that. They come in handy, surprisingly. Even if the person you know doesn't use it, they will know or have friends that will use it. Guaranteed.
There are always those people at cons who have the breakdown and then they go posting on social media, I'm desperate. Does anybody have a repair kit? And you know that you're that guy and you're like, yeah, I have one.
Yep.
Come meet me here. Or you have those people who go around in the repair kit costumes now, the cosplay repair station people who just do nothing. But you don't want to have to depend on those people because they won't always be there. So it's always good, especially if you're competing on stage, to carry a small kit with bags are the perfect size to keep with you.
They carry
somebody
well.
Somebody needs to invent a pocket-sized pencil. Not a gun, but just something where you like push on the side of the pen and the nozzle heats up and it just kind of squirts it out, almost like the Three Doodles.
Oh, okay, yeah.
It needs to do just like that because that way you only have enough room to fit one stick in there. The body of the pencil, it doesn't stick out the back like a gun. Battery powered, because you won't always have a socket around. and just heat it up, low temp sticks only, draw it, go. Patent draw pending.
Go. Patent pending. We got to have a name for it, though.
I will come up with something. You know I'm very good at coming
I
up with
I know you will. I'm fully aware that you will. Oh, goodness.
It'll be called the pen seal because it seals things. There you go.
My God. she's hit her pun for the day.
My one for the day.
The one for the day.
We're number one. Anyways, that's pretty much what I've got for basic do not already involve gift cards, because those always come on the list anyway. So you got?
All right, so here are my beautiful and brilliant ideas. I guess let's go ahead and start with the first thing, that since we talked about wigs previously, a wig styling kit. And this can be everything from having a wide tooth comb to getting bobby pins to getting these lovely portable wig stands, which pretty much transforms any flat surface into a wig stand for you. Screw the bottom on, and I'm actually using this currently. Wig goes here. It keeps your wig stable. It's brilliant. And while we're on the subject of that, styrofoam heads. We go through a lot of these, surprisingly. They don't come with duct tape. You may want to consider adding colorful duct tape for your cosplay friend so they can pad the back of it. But, you know, and they're actually relatively cheap. I mean, you could spend anywhere from $4 to $8 for each one of them, but you get a friend like two or three of these, they're incredibly appreciative of it. Trust me. But then also have to think about like the styling tools that go with it, like Got to Be Gel and Got to Be Free Spray. Every cosplayer uses these. They are the best hair gels out there for wigs. So we love them, and the more we can get, the better. But then other little things like, you know, a flat iron and a curling iron and plastic clips. I mean, these are just standard styling tools that you see in salons. We need them too.
And they don't. A set of T-pins.
Mm-hmm. T-pins are fabulous. They're awesome. And they don't have to be like wig specific stuff. I mean, you can use any normal hairstyling product on a wig. Wigs have gone a long way in the past couple of years that it's not going to do any extra damage to it. So standard stuff. It's not a big deal. Or if you have a friend that you know who does like a lot of lace front wigs, a lacing needle. It's one of those silly things you don't think about until you realize, oh, I could add more stuff here if I had a needle to do it. A lacing needle makes everything so much easier for wig styling. If I could find mine, that'd be great. I still have no idea where it is. I bought it, have yet to use it because I have no idea where it is. I think having some organization in this mess would be grand. Amber is laughing at me.
Maybe you need a magnetic pin cushion.
No, you know what I need? I need, and this is the stupid one that I added to my list. It's called a Tracker R. It's a GPS tracker that's maybe about this big, and you can attach it to a lot of stuff, like things that you may constantly lose, like your favorite pair of scissors or a lacing needle. And it's all able to...
Or when somebody steals your favorite pair of scissors and you want to know who took your fabric scissors to go cut non-fabric things.
It's only about $10. And the great thing is that it syncs to their phone with an app. So that way they can quickly just pull up the app and track it in whatever location that they're in. So they don't have to lose stuff ever again. And like I said, it's only like about that big. So it attaches to almost anything short of, a tiny ass needle. I thought of some really weird stuff. It's something that a cosplayer might actually need and use, me. So keeping in line with the kit thing, I thought about doing a sewing machine cleaning kit. Because some people don't realize that your machine may need maintenance. You may not want to actually go and take it somewhere to get it maintained. Or if you're someone like me and you have like a Viking, not every shop knows how to service them properly, unfortunately.
Or can do it in a timely fashion.
Exactly. You may be on a waiting list. It may take longer than a week. It may take 2 to 3 weeks because they have so much they have to go through. So things like getting oil, because yes, your machine does need to be oiled. You know, you got to get a microfiber cloth. Those things are fabulous.
This is sewing machine oil. This is called Sewer's Aid.
Yep.
It looks basically like eye drop fluid, please, for the love of God, cries. And you basically just put it on the moving parts in the innards of your machine, and that's it.
Yeah. I have a taller bottle version of it that actually has a spout that goes up and out, which is great because it gets me to the inside of the machine without me having to take apart too much of it. So that's another option too. So yeah, I said microfiber cloth, a can of spray air. Good way to get some of that dust out from areas that you really can't reach, or if it's areas of the machine that you can't take apart.
Please note that you cannot ship those.
Yeah, that's the downside. Downside.
Yeah. So local gifts only on the compressed air.
No kidding. And then, oops, and then this one came to mind too, and I didn't even realize it. Consider getting yourself a laptop repair kit. And all it is just a set of tools that are tiny. They're meant for laptops, but you can use them on sewing machines. They are epically awesome. This was maybe a $20 investment I made a decade ago. No, more than a decade ago. Maybe 13 years ago. I still have all my tools in here, and they are fabulous. They're wonderful for helping me take apart my sewing machine so I can clean it properly. Totally worth it. And I use it for other things too. It's been great for prop building and whatnot. So laptop repair kit, very helpful for cosplay.
You may also want to throw in there a spare set of universal needles, because those will fit on pretty much any sewing machine, and needles do dull after time. They need replacing. And also a spare set of bobbins. You'd be surprised how many bobbins you go through. Because people don't just run out their bobbins and then load them with a separate thing of thread. They'll have several bobbins of different colors loaded at once. So you can actually get, and mine is actually sitting on the counter over there, but you can get a little bobbin box that you can store all of your bobbins in. Speaking of storage. So just, they come in, I think, packs of five. So you can just get a little set of five. They're plastic or metal. Take your pick. Just get them a set of bobbins. Get them a little bobbin storage box. A couple needles.
You're good.
You're good.
And most bobbins are universal now. So, I mean, they fit most machines. So you should be okay.
Yep.
So the other thing that I had in mind, too, was getting a sewing machine foot. Again, it's another one of those things that as your cosplayer, your machine probably comes with maybe 2 to 5 feet standard. Or if you get like a really basic machine, you got the 1 foot and you're like, okay, cool. You don't realize that there is a bevy of sewing foots out there that make your life immensely easier. And you realize, how did I live without one?
Sewing foots?
Yeah. The sewing feet are beautiful.
It's very Bob Ross of you.
I know, right?
Anyways.
For example, if you like to make very big frilly dresses, there's this thing called a ruffle foot. It is the most beautiful thing in the entire universe. And you'll wonder how you manage to survive without a ruffle foot. The ruffle foot is brilliant. Now, keep in mind that these can be very sewing machine specific. So you may want to find out from your friend or your family member what kind of machine they have before you invest in these, because some of these can be a little pricey, which kind of sucks. But that's okay. Usually you can get them in like in the $5 to $25 range, and you don't want to spend $25 on a foot that they can't use. It doesn't really help. But I mean, they've got like zipper foots. I mean, I said the ruffling foot. Oh, ruffling foot, so pretty. Great. let me see. I mean, I know they have a rolled hem foot for my machine. I mean, you got walking foots. You got foot specifically for buttons. Those are cool too. So
walking feet are wonderful. If you have fabric that doesn't feed evenly, especially a pile fabric like velvet, velveteen, leather, vinyl, anything that's non-woven that your machine really doesn't like and tries to eat, walking feet will save you.
God, yes.
All it is a sewing machine foot that has a little wheel, and the wheel feeds the fabric. That's it.
It's beautiful.
Also, invisible zipper foot if you work with invisible zippers.
I really need to get myself one of those. I'm kind of getting tired of doing those by hand.
Those are actually also useful for making piping.
They are, yeah. I've seen a couple of people do that, and it's like, oh, that's a cool idea. I didn't think about that before. Mm-hmm. All right, so next up I have for those who are really big into historical patterns or, you know, make a lot of corsets, get them steel boning. I know that sounds really dumb, but that's like gold for us. You get a steel boning along with a good pair of boning clippers and then the tips that go with them. that's easily a $30 gift that your cosplayer will adore you for. Because that goes a long way, a really long way. And I don't mean the pre-cut steel bonings. You want to get the roll of it, the roll of its best. That way they can cut things to their own specifications. What else did I have? On my list, I also have, as dumb as this sounds, a bolt of muslin. Like, if you really want to get somebody fabric, get them a bolt of muslin. Because we use this for pattern making. We use this for mock-ups. We use this for so many things. And it's a relatively inexpensive gift, but it will have multiple uses. And it can last for quite some time. Because it's not just, you know, oh, I need 2 yards of muslin. No, you get them a bolt, they'll be grateful for a long time.
And that's muslin with an N as in November.
Yes. Another thing that came to mind was leather measuring tape. I've used one of these before and I keep meaning to get myself one of them. It's more than just measuring tape in a nice little leather pouch that looks fancy. Actually, some of them are made out of leather and they last longer than traditional measuring tapes. Some people have actually mentioned on one that I saw on Amazon that theirs has lasted for like 15 years. So it's definitely an investment piece. They are a little bit more expensive. They can go anywhere from like $35 to $80 because it is leather, but you're investing in it. So that's the important thing. Next up I have listed on here, sewing books, books on patterns, or even books on costuming in the entertainment industry. There are so many cool sewing books out there that are more than just coffee table books, and they're great resources for cosplayers. And I know it's something that people don't think about because, you know, books are kind of going out of style unless they're a coffee table book. Sewing books have so much use for cosplayers on multiple levels. Even like the historical costuming or like the archaeology sewing books. Those are some pretty cool things about, you know, the history of fabric. How did this fabric came to be and all that stuff. It's cool stuff to know. And the last thing that I have on my list is customized gifts like bags, mugs, or sketchbooks. And things that you can get off of like Zazzle or Cafe Press that you can customize for your cosplayer. Sea mug.
Or the bags we give away at all cons cosplay contests every year.
Yeah, exactly. And funny enough, when I did that painting and dyeing panel for A&T a couple of weeks ago, Kat Chan brought her stuff in the tote bag that she won. And I was like, yay, I feel so happy. All my embroidery stuff is in a tote bag that I have from Reading Rainbow. Tote bags are great. They come in handy. And because it's customized and personal for me, it's even better.
Or if you wanted to, say, make somebody a cosplay repair kit bag that's personalized and sew just little pouches into it so that they can just put various repair things into it. Kind of like the roll of that you can get patterns for.
Mm-hmm. And sketchbooks is kind of one of those oddball things that most people don't think about because you're like, oh, well, you cosplay, so you already have your reference material. You don't need to draw a whole lot of things out. Not always the case, because even though I have the image in front of me, I still like to sketch out what the materials are, where the seams are going to fall, how I want it to look on me. And so it helps having that sketchbook there. And you can always have the covers customized to your friend or your family member.
The last thing I had on my list that isn't quite cosplay directly related, cosplay relaxation. This one has to be a little bit more customized, and I only say that because you have to know the allergies of the person to whom you are giving it. So obviously, if they are lactose intolerant, you would not be giving them a milkshake.
Please don't.
But you can assemble little sundries, pastry or sweets that they can eat, things so that they can relax in a hot bath, whether it's bath, just a nice little hand lotion, whatever. Be very aware of if they're allergic to scents, various smelly things. Or you can even just give them a gift card out to a local spa. I mean, just a little something, because we all know that as cosplayers, we get really stressed in making cosplay sometimes.
Yeah, we do.
Especially when we're coming up on a deadline and we're really good about forgetting to relax. So you can always just assemble a little kit, even if it has one of those little mug sets with hot chocolate in them. That's great.
Those things are cool. Even though I can't have them, those things are cool.
They will use it. They will use it, and they will love it. I mean, they have little kits that you can get, little nibbles, little things to just kind of help you. Whether it's before the con, the deep breath before the plunge, or after the con, going, back to real life.
Yeah. Or restaurant gift cards.
That was not on my list, actually.
Oh, darn.
If you're so inclined. I mean, you can even do gift cards to local costume shops if you have one. I mean, we have Dallas Vintage here. We have Costume and Dance. We have Spirit Halloween that comes around. You can even do Party City if they have things that they purchase from Party City. Even if it's just little things like that. They don't have to be massive gifts, you guys.
Yeah, I think
customers
that's the thing.
Are very appreciative.
Yeah, I think that's the thing. People are like, oh, well, you're a sewer. That means you must want a sewing machine and all that stuff. And it's like, no, I like my sewing machine. I need little things, little tools to help build up, because those are the tools that I'm going to use way more often than my sewing machine. By and large, I use probably, God, I'm sure I use my measuring tape way more than I use my sewing machine, because I'm constantly pattern drafting. I mean, it's the little tools that make up the, it's the little tools that mean so much. As silly as that sounds. A
friend who's a photographer. You don't have to buy them a camera. They've already got most of what they need. So why not get them a really nice embroidered bag for their camera gear?
Yeah, exactly.
Or maybe embroider them a strap for their bag, because maybe they already have a camera bag, but they don't have a strap for it. Or you can get them a little pack of a lens cleaning cloths and a little spray with the cleaning solution in it. Just little things, just to show that, you know, you're thinking of them. Cosplayers, if you have a photographer that you work with often with your modeling gigs, maybe consider getting them just a small camera maintenance kit.
We're all about the little things. We like the little things. They save our lives.
Great things come in small, just man.
They do. Is that the tagline for the show now?
I actually be titled Big Things, Small Packages.
Okay, I'm cool with that.
If it doesn't fit, then it will be Big Things, Small Packs.
I'm okay with that too.
Or maybe small boxes. Or so, I'll make it fit within our little website caption.
Okay, there we go. I had to type it down so I remember to put that on the video I upload.
But that's just to give you guys a little bit of a suggestion, an insight into things that you can possibly get your fellow cosplayer friends and costumer friends. If you even just want to do a card exchange, that is fantastic. You can get custom-made cards with photos of various costumes on it.
There you go.
Very, very simple gift. And that way you stay in touch with your friends and just let them know that you care about them. Because that's, honestly, it's more about that, letting people know that you care about them, than what you actually get, if anything.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason that we bring up these sorts of gifts right now is just because everything's about to go on sale.
Buy now. It's cheaper.
So if you're going to get them anyway, you may as well pay less for them so that you have that money to put into other things like cosplay and more fabric. So this way you can still purchase these items and not have to worry about budgeting as heavily for them. And the best time to purchase them is actually not necessarily on Black Friday or Cyber Monday, for that matter. It's actually the week before.
Mm-hmm.
Because the stores want to clear out all their old inventory so that they've got space for their Black Friday and Cyber Monday inventory. So check them out the week before, and they may actually be running some seriously good deals for you.
Of course, if you want to be the bestest friend in the universe, you can always get them a sewing or an embroidery machine. Or hey, even a dress form. If you want to spend the money, if you want to look like you're the coolest person in the universe, but I mean... Amber shaking her head. Hey,
no,
so who wants to get me an embroidery? Hey, I would love an embroidery machine. I'm just saying.
I'm not going to ask anybody to spend that kind of money on me ever.
I won't either.
Just,
I
no.
I felt really guilty when my mom gave me this sewing machine a couple years ago. I was like, this is too much. I can't. I mean, I love it, but I felt really guilty afterwards for a while. Like, this is so expensive.
And if you guys don't feel like purchasing anything physical for your friends, something fantastic that you can do is you can make a donation in your friend's name.
Oh yeah, there's always that as an option.
Pick donate. Your favorite charity, donate it, and usually they will send a card of thank you. So that you know that that money is going towards a good cause. And I know if you do some of the wildlife foundations, sometimes they'll send you a plushie. I know, not directly cosplayer related, but we're all about the charitable giving and volunteering this time of year, so I kind of had to throw it in there.
Is all good. But yeah, you don't have to think super big when you need to get a gift for your cosplayer or customer friend. Any type of tool that's out there, they will appreciate and they will adore.
And they will use it.
Mm-hmm. Probably the only thing you shouldn't do is, other than getting muslin, don't buy their fabric for them. They might hurt you. Some people are very particular about that stuff. I know I am.
If you get basic patterning cloth, like canvas, yeah. Or heck, you can even get them a roll of craft paper, and that's craft with a K,
mm-hmm.
which is also known as butcher paper. And that's what you use to make patterns on.
That works beautifully, too. I have no problems with that. Yeah, somebody wants to give me a bunch of...
Yeah, if you don't want to get a bolt of muslin, you can always get a roll of craft paper.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, if somebody gave me, like, a roll of freezer paper, because I do so much applique, I'd be like, done. I'm a happy camper. And those things are relatively cheap at the grocery store, but it's like, hey, one less thing I have to buy. Cool.
Yep. So that is our Cosmos. That is our Cosmos prompt for this year. It's not actually our Christmas episode yet, Kat. But
we're
this
not there
year
yet.
You can get your shopping out of the way.
Exactly. We're helping
and
you out
you're
earlier.
Going to start personalizing. Yeah, if you're going to start personalizing gifts, now's the time to start.
Gosh, yes, because it's like what?
A while.
How long is it? It's not even. It's less than 2 months. That I know.
For what? Christmas?
Yeah.
6 weeks. That's why I said 6 weeks. Yeah, come on, you haven't been to retail stores and seen all of the Christmas stuff?
No, I have not been to retail stores.
Plank and everything else. Aww.
No, I have been dealing with Christmas at work since June. I'm sick of Christmas.
I have coworkers playing Christmas.
My face will stay like this because no, I'm tired of Christmas. I'm done with Christmas.
Go okay.
We were talking about Christmas before we were even talking about our fall stuff. Like, no.
So long. There's only one Christmas song I don't like, and I'm trying to think of the name of it.
Oh, crap.
I want to say it's a Paul McCartney song for Christmas. It will come to me eventually.
Paul McCartney Christmas song? Okay, now we're Googling. Hang on.
Nah.
I don't know one. I like Paul McCartney. Paul McCartney, Wonderful Christmas Time?
That's the one. Can't stand that song.
I see the video of it. It looks interesting.
can't stand that song. Give me any other Christmas song. I'll live. There's a few others that I'm not fond of. But that one I cannot stand.
Oh, he's got some electric stuff going on in it. Wow. The video is a little trippy.
Yes. The song is also trippy.
He's wearing a Doctor Who scarf, though.
Also, not a bad idea to get your fellow cosplay friends, or nerdy friends for that matter.
Yeah,
make
nerdy
them
attire.
Nerdy things. Yes.
Yeah. And there's so many places where you can get a lot of nerdy things these days. I mean, everything from like what? Hot Topic has nerdy things. A ton of nerdy things now. You can get it anywhere. It's fairly relatively easy to get to. Just make sure it's in the genre of things that they like.
Or they're generically nerdy.
Mm-hmm.
Get a pair of quilter's gloves or compression gloves for those who have hands that tend to hurt after a while or whose hands get cold easily. Great gift. Great gift. Or a neck warmer.
Yeah.
Also a simple thing. Great gift. Yeah. Definitely. All right. Anything else?
That's all I got, Scotty.
Beam me up.
Can do. As long as you're not a red shirt.
We'll see you guys in episode. No, I'm actually a blue shirt today. I guess that makes me medical.
Yeah, I'm kind of green, but it's close to blue. Does that count?
Close enough. We will see you guys in episode 129. Bye, everybody.
Remember, social media up here, down here. Chat with us. Say hi. We'll say hi back. Bye, guys.